if you want to leave earlier, you will be asked to give some feedback. We are being filmed, and this film is live streaming on the internet right now, and it will be projected in this room tomorrow. Can you tell us about it?
I don't know if I can put it in words.
What was it, Miss Samson?
Maybe you have to be a bit more concrete about what this is for you.
What it is for you?
Okay, first you. Way to make you feel repressed by something, and in a positive way, when you feel hurt by someone.
Hurt?
Hurt, not hurt.
Okay, so practically, have you been a member of a group, or you feel what is this collective subject practically? What was or is this in your life?
When you're a part of a group and you act as a part of the group, when you're not not determined by it, but you know what you have to do in order to make the group feel comfortable or not comfortable.
Have you been in such a group?
Maybe.
Which?
I think it's always around us, maybe. Like, there are many of these groups.
Could you name?
That's very personal, I think.
Could be a football team or first therapist. I mean, the question was not necessarily so personal. I didn't ask you to reveal your sexual identity or something.
Yeah, but in a way, because as we speak about groups, what I said was for all groups, and then I should be a bit more precise about which group, and that is mainly always personal because you asked me.
Anyone else? Anyone that wants to share some experience about being part of a group or a collective subject or sense collectivity?
Yeah. I have some questions about the queers. Is that a community? Because actually I was thinking about it today, so it's really cool to be asked that.
About what? About which community?
About how your people find themselves to be a community all over the world, wherever they come from. It's like a little bit given for granted that you're sisters. I think, I don't know. Anybody agree with that? Sometimes queer people feel like we're all part of this community automatically.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I do.
And then,
do you think for you, is it the same, the word community and collective?
No, it's not the same. I'm adding some of my thoughts of today into your question. I can relate these two things to each other.
So which are the characteristics of the queer community that you think make it a collective subject? Or
I'm not very sure, actually.
What
so
are
that's
the,
my question.
The characteristics that make it feel or seem as a community?
The fact that their identity is not questioned.
I didn't understand.
The fact that their identity is in question. Maybe this is the common truth.
It is in question. That's not completely true, though. No? It's a puzzle.
Or the question identity. Or the question identity. Because straight people don't question identity, as you are honest on that.
Can I have a paper and pen? Is anyone hot for one?
Well, what do you think is a collective self? What would be the definition?
I don't know. I'm trying to work it out. Maybe the loss of identity is one of the reasons, but what are the characteristics that there are and they make you feel that it is a community? Like, I don't know, solidarity or
maybe it's more about shared experiences.
Yeah. Shared experiences?
Yeah.
Okay.
No.
Yeah,
it's
maybe
not.
Or sharing, willing to share experiences, willing to generosity, like to be part of a community, you've got to be a bit generous.
Don't they share a common trauma or something? Isn't, maybe for some it isn't, but.
Yeah, but then everybody shares a common trauma, should be a collective self, or a community, or we want to call it, and that isn't the case.
Maybe we can have collectivities in the name of the common trauma.
Yeah, but that doesn't really happen. I mean, it happens.
It doesn't it? I saw a manifestation of the body.
Of the what?
How they call it?
The people of Pontus. There was a genocide from the Greeks of Pontus in Turkey, and they celebrated it recently. They remembered, not celebrated.
Yeah, they manifested against the.
Yeah,
yeah.
All these things are
true.
So you said it was shared, but of course you didn't say if you have experienced it, but I guess you have. Okay, so to be heard. What else?
I don't understand. Is it a condition to be heard?
Maybe one of the conditions?
Mm-hmm. Okay, come on. I need some brainstorming.
Anyone else has experienced the collectivity in their lives and wants to share?
Has a, I don't know, a common purpose, a common goal.
Yeah.
I mean, something to be achieved.
Share a goal.
Share a purpose. I prefer the word purpose.
Okay.
Yeah, but I can feel collectivity when I'm stuck with a lot of people on the bus in traffic.
I guess this is common trauma.
Yeah, you also feel collectivity.
I don't know.
Like, if you're traveling on the bus, especially in Athens here, the buses get cramped, like, it's full, it's stuffy, and then on top of that, you get, or the truck breaks down, or you get stuck in traffic, and then you have this shared experience and this collectivity with everybody who is upset or starts laughing or is joking, and it's still, and at the same point, at the same time, you all have the same goal, you want to go. And sometimes that feels like a collective, well, it's collective suffering. But it also feels like a bonding experience that you can share with complete strangers.
So collective suffering.
Not just suffering.
Yeah.
It's a collective, no, it's a shared
experience.
Circumstances create a common ground that brings this collectivity.
Yeah.
Are you from Athens?
I live from.
But you're not originally Greek? Or
no.
Where are you from?
I'm from the Netherlands.
Mm. Is it different here compared to the Netherlands?
Yes, it's very different.
So what is the sense of collectivity in the Netherlands, for example, for you?
The sense of collectivity in the Netherlands. Actually, the sense of collectivity in the Netherlands is much less than the sense of collectivity here. And I think that in the Netherlands, it's much more self-centered. Everybody does their thing. It's much more self-focused here. It's much more based on a society, on families, so on collectives, actually. Here you have the concept of that's your social group.
It's your gang.
People you hang out with. And it seems very odd if you break out of that. If you have dinner by yourself, or if you go to the movie by yourself, everything has to be done in kind of a collective. I mean, for me, that's a big difference from the Netherlands.
Do you like it?
I struggle with it, but I like it. Yeah.
You struggle with it?
Yeah, because it's completely different from what I was used to.
So which are the problems?
You're very focused on problems. The problem is that really it's not accepted, or it's less accepted socially to do things by yourself, or to go out by yourself, or I can say to eat by yourself. And maybe I'm a person who generally likes to be by himself also.
And you, where are you from?
England.
How you experienced then collectivity and formal?
Not strongly, I wouldn't say. I mean, it's quite atomistic society, quite separate, and I have a tendency towards that. I'm a bit of a loner myself, so, you know, sometimes I don't want to talk to anyone. I do, but feel estranged from everyone else, and just end up.
This is a common experience also for me in what regards me and the collective estrangement. So, could we have a collective for people that they feel estranged?
Well, it kind of is, isn't there, on the internet? I mean, there are kind of communities on the internet for people who aren't good with people, I think.
Do you think this is the reason why we are using the camera and the
lights? Yeah, maybe. I haven't thought about it yet.
It helps me. I think it's a hindrance for me, actually, the fact that it's being filmed. Yeah. I mean, I'm also used to it because I'm an artist myself, but it seems for me to be, oh, I wish the camera wasn't there in a way, you know, because that's also this thought. Yeah, it really not personal.
But there's quite a lot of people who, it's kind of taboo to talk about, but there's quite a lot of people who don't fit in very well. But obviously, we don't want to shout about it. You know that I'm not very good with people, and they tend to be on their own, live on their own. Older people as well, you know, don't have anyone to talk to. I'm talking about England, I don't know about Greece, but...
One thing that bothers me in the collectives is that always someone more capable in speaking or in appearing in front of public gains much more power.
Yeah. There's hardly no hierarchy in a collective, I think. There'll always be some kind of hierarchy going. Finally, yeah.
So in a way, it is a characteristic hierarchy.
It's difficult to keep away from that, right?
Could we imagine a horizontal thing?
Maybe there is
a hierarchy or originality.
I guess it depends on collective to collective dynamics, you know. The personalities within that also. It's not a for sure there'll be hierarchies.
So what about you? Did you at some point of your life experience collectivity?
Well, it's just a group of friends really. But I think that and then of course in institutions which of course there's hierarchy. But even when it's a group of friends, it could have some strange dynamics. So sometimes then it doesn't work out, then it falls apart. Yeah. I think as soon as hierarchy comes in, it falls apart.
I would suggest that we come back to language and through this problem because it's inherent. It's in the way that people express themselves. It shows a lot of things, like your cultural background, your if you're straight, gay, whatever, you know, like it shows, like so much. So, and I think the problem is that we identify the voice with the person who is expressing the voice. Could we imagine a collective having a common voice? Would it be more horizontal if someone had to speak with only one voice, and that was the voice of the collective only?
I mean, it's okay if it's, I don't know, I think there has to be a larger political idea if that's going to happen, which will push the collective what it needs to do. Like the Gorilla Girls, you know, then you just have these, you don't really know who they are, or they're always wearing masks, but then they have a political agenda, so. They kind of, but if you have no political agenda, then it can get into some kind of personal politics. You know, there's always going to be, so it's better if the politics is really wide. I think then it goes in a good way. Otherwise, there's always going to be some politics. So you've got to choose whether you want a wider politics or your narrower, like finally, you know, so just yourself.
So we have to imagine the goal first.
Yeah, for sure. And make sure that everyone knows what the goal is and is on. Yeah, everyone should know.
Okay, so the goal, I guess, is very important.
Yeah, or the same
so
goal.
So if we want to help the collective subject to emerge here between us, we should have a goal.
Yeah, the same goal. So like, yeah, more
that's
or less.
That's what we're doing.
Yeah.
Hmm?
That's what you would like to do.
Yeah, maybe, if you want.
The collectives have emerged in the people involved in this conversation.
Could we?
We can do everything.
I don't know. Do we share a goal? Could we find a goal, a common goal?
I think that by now we already have a goal. We are all part of a conversation. No one has excited himself. And we all try to think in the direction of a collective subject and figure something out. So there is a goal already, since no one is sitting there just observing.
I have a suggestion of a device that we could use. I would like to show it and show how it works.
Okay.
I do. Like to gather around. Would like us to try this. So from now the collective subject can.
Collective subject. I am the collective subject.
somehow you are now the collective subject.
So this will be the voice of the collective.
Now we talk as one. Tight say. And say what the collective subject is. I think we have to make the common goal more clear. Is that to understand what the collective subject is? Da, you understand? Say da, do you understand?
Sounded like a question.
What? I did not hear you. Okay, then.
Yeah, then what?
Getting back to the question. Now I'm confused. Say I'm confused. Are we still a collective subject, taking the viewer? Since no one is actually part of the conversation,
stop it.
Do you have another suggestion?
I like the talking button. No. It's not that we were going to get anywhere in the hour, but still.
Why did you use the computer?
We said, right, some terms of our structures, in the base of how you speak and who you are, you, how would you,
some weight, I don't know, like personality weight.
Yeah, but that only happens over the internet. Here we all know how each other looks and everything. So,
I mean, it's not that. If you're right, it's not different, no?
Yeah.
I don't see the difference.
And then it's a male voice, so it's like, why am I suddenly speaking with a male voice?
I can say that.
And while I was typing, I really thought of what you said before about how singularities may become a collective subject by being on the internet. And, I don't know if I will not find it good enough, but how they...
I speak with the voice of the collective.
Yeah, the ecosystem, not get that.
Listen to me.
It doesn't matter because now I want to say that it reminds me a little bit of 1984 and how can, I don't know, an unseen, let's say an identity, a substance that we cannot see can call itself a collective subject, even if...
Let's try something to reason.
I didn't hear you. Why I think that the collective subject may be somewhere here, and we, you know, just pick it and say something and then leave it again there, in the intermediate space, so for someone else to take. And now there is someone saying that they are the collective subject for us.
The tools have been hijacked, so you kind of automated the whole thing. And if you refuse to use that, then you almost can be spoken over. She was in the middle of a sentence, and suddenly this kind of was totally without any manners, in a way. So you kind of break through just basic human courtesy in that sense also.
Yeah, but of course I interact with you, but it would be very different when you interact with a louder voice and headphones, but in a way it feels very familiar, doesn't it? I mean, you know that something more lively is here, but there is always someone else taking the power of this liveliness, and you know. That interrupts you in a way. I mean,
to be heard.
Having in fact, you know, like comfort, not comfortable, but having
to be heard.
In that situation again, I mean, I have been there. I
to be heard.
I can think of so many invisible collectives that take my collective subject away. No, it is
collective suffering.
seems a bit too ambitious to speak with one voice. That seems a bit like an unachievable goal. I mean, it seems like it would be a bit, it would end up a bit totalitarian. If that was your aim, it would seem impossible.
Alienation.
There's always going to be an outgroup, people who don't fit in. So if you have one voice, it doesn't seem to go with a pluralistic society. Because what if you disagree with the one voice? What if you...
Hierarchy.
A cosmetic voice. Can you find the source of human voice?
Sorry?
Have you experienced your voice being heard?
I've experienced my voice being heard.
Yeah. For example, this dimension of this phone now capturing what you're saying. And if you think about what this phone captures, you can see yourself from the outside. I speak about this dimension of you and your voice. Have you ever spoken speak? This is what happens, you know, you hear your voice spoken.
Yes. What's the question, sir?
If the human is the proprietary of his voice, who is the proprietary of human voice?
Of every human voice?
Yeah, of my voice. Who is commanding the voice to speak and say what it says? I say whatever I want, without limitations.
The collective subject.
It depends what you say it and who you say it to, when you say it.
Who is saying
it? It depends.
I am saying it.
I mean, the subject.
Myself, me.
Yeah, individual, self, and subject are the three same things. Are the same things.
It's not about the same thing.
And what
individual, self,
and subject.
And subject.
Are three words that describing the same thing?
Not about you.
No, that's why there are three words. I mean, two words cannot have the same meaning.
Yeah. What do they mean?
In a question of who's speaking, whose voice is speaking, then probably the answer is self. Because
who is the self? What means the self?
Self is the closest to Self is the closest to a body combined with personality. When I speak of me, I speak of myself. While subject also has an object, and it has more philosophical and political connotations. And individual,
it is about the collective subject.
The opposite. Of collective. So if I speak
not
of
about you, you.
An individual, it's me putting
not
all
about
the
you.
Interest on the singularity of that person.
Not about you. Not about you. Not about you. Speak about a collective subject.
We try to define the subject in order to define a collective subject, but we have a problem with the subject.
I don't understand that. Not the owner of your voice, not the other.
Yeah. I don't know, I'm determined from a lot of outside factors, like my unconscious, my sociopolitical and economic situation.
Your unconscious is pretty inside,
actually. Inside,
you're saying you're determined by a lot of outside factors, and you start by saying my unconscious, which I think is, by definition, something that at least comes from out of yourself. I mean, it has been shaped by outside factors, but still, you are the one who makes the mix and makes from the input, makes the output.
Mm-hmm. So, there are other factors also, men that find another reason why we're not ourselves or we're not free. Except Freud, they are thinking about Marx also. We are processes of the material reality that creates us. We are an impersonal good to power, Nietzsche. We are not in the center of the universe. We are superior beings than animals. We have our language. No, I mean that these are my own values.
I can have language. Am I superior? Listen carefully that the audience is your instrument. Play in order to practically understand how we are generally instrumentalized. I prepare the audience with concepts, questions, and movements as a way to explore the dissonance that exists between the individual narcissism that capitalism promotes and our social capacity, between how we conceive ourselves as free individuals of agency and the fact that we are socially determined by capitalist relations, technology, and ideology.
I think you're right about the first thing you said, that there has to be some outside kind of push, and then which kind of makes you grab at identities. Mm-hmm. But if there's no threat, then you don't really feel the need to say, okay, we've got this in common, because there's nothing you're trying to keep safe also in that sense, you know, or protect, because there's no threat.
There's no?
Threat.
Yeah. Where?
There's no danger from, like, if there's a storm outside, then we might be more of a collective, because we're stuck here, you know, so that kind of. But you're all of our free will, and we don't really also know what anything about the next person, unless you're friends with the person. But it's really.
What does it mean, how the collective subject on art in this context?
Yeah, there's no, I don't know what connector subject means actually, but there's no real way of, I mean, it just, you can have a nice conversation, but there's no label you can kind of give the group essentially.
Do you think it would be the same if we did this conversation outside of the industry?
I was wondering, could you just kind of, it just needs this kind of outside. I'm just even speaking politically, just an outside threat that makes you feel, here I'm part of this country or this town or village or building.
A very common thing in nationalism is something, the personification of the bad in someone, but it's threatening the pleasure of the country. For example, for Greece, these are the Turks, and they're challenging the territory and whatever, everybody knows. And we are the good, this is the narrative in which one of the most important narratives that exist in the Greek nationalism. So maybe we need the
other.
I think Europe is taking that place right now. I think somehow Europe is taking that place, a lot of times.
Germany, yeah.
How is this documentary being seen? Like that it's in Kassel and Athens. Is it going down well with the artists, Greek artists as such?
I have been some critique about.
Because there's a similar situation in, I'm from Goa, and there's a similar thing about, even to do with the museum. I heard that this National Museum of Modern Art was, the first show is with the documentary or something like that, yeah. There was a certain thing in Goa also, for 7 years, the local artists have been trying to get it into a museum, contemporary art museum, and it didn't happen, and the government suddenly moved really fast when it was the Delhi Art Organization. So there was a little bit of happy it's happening, but at the same time, you kind of didn't do it for us, but you just wide open doors for somebody else who had more funding, and yeah, definitely had more funding. Anyway, what I meant was, you really just have to have the other to form a collective, I feel. Sometimes.
You have?
Yeah, you need to have. And if it's an artist collective also, you could also say that there is the other, because there's only this many galleries and that much of the art world. So it's also, with an artist collective, it's kind of a little bit about there being so many artists, so it could also go that way, that you kind of get a stronger force with 5 artists or 3 artists. It has also, that's also been reasons for artist collective.
In order, I try to understand the collective subject. Do you think that these artists that produce the critique over this event, do they form a collective subject?
I don't really know what collective subject means, actually. So I know what a collective means.
Me neither, that's why I'm actually discussing.
Is it the subject of the collective? Is the collective itself a subject?
Does a collective have a subject?
Today, I think insurance says more than everybody uses the PC to speak, and this way we can make a more entertaining situation.
I didn't understand.
The collective voice.
It is a pity we might go so fast. At first, the conversation was going well. I would like to see what would happen if we put all these characteristics of the collective subject all together.
Something,
and
in order for
to
do something, you need other people to help you with it.
The
negative
one, negative. Yeah. Oh, no, but I think the danger is, of course, a very clear incentive, and it helps forming a common interest. But the same could be a book club where people want to share stories with each other.
Set a fire extinguisher or something. If this would lead people to come together, if this would be a danger, or if this is not a danger anyway, because here we are part of a performance and not part of a real situation.
Mm. In common experiences also create.
I think that.
Pain does in my life.
The one time that happened actually inside the space to form something that you could name as a spark of a collective subject. This was in the name of the absence of someone that was annoying. It happened 2 days ago, but someone who was annoying left the space because he said something that he didn't like or whatever, he changed his mind. And the people that remained here blamed this guy that left, and they were all named Yoros, trying to interpret this other. So when you have another, you are an identity or something like that. Maybe next time we need a strong other inside the room, someone that is annoying or someone that does something completely out of the blue, in order for the rest of the people out after this person stops or disappears, they create a collective subject in the name of this negative identification, I don't know, like something like that. I think also other people notice that you need something in order to identify as a subject.
Okay.
So we need
too simple.
Yes,
too simple.
Maybe we could try that though, because I don't know, it's a hypothesis. You could see if it works, like if you can force a collective subject to be created, or it's just a miracle that happens once in a long
time. Well, there was a disturbing factor, and this was the electronic voice, but it was introduced as kind of part of a collective. So if we can say that the collective was starting to happen inside here, but there was not a very clear opposition to this machine, and it's amazing how much power it keeps just because of the anonymity it provides to the one writing there, not just because of the different the volume of the
voice. Am I disturbing?
But it does not provide anonymity.
It's because it's part of a performance as well. We're sort of waiting for it to say something. You know, it doesn't always.
Why do you think it's anonymity?
it's almost like a hierarchical tool in a way. I've got if.
It is interesting because I feel very comfortable while writing here.
Is something like hierarchical?
I mean,
I felt like I am alone.
It's just a delay between you formulating your thought and us listening, not the voice. It's just this delay.
I mean, if we had run with it, which we kind of didn't, you know, we didn't kind of shut up and say, please pass the computer, I want to say something. It's like only the person with the computer gets to speak. So, that thing. It's like a mic, basically.
I understand that it is a device of power, but you did not do anything to stop me.
Like
you were elected.
Yeah, don't get it.
We could have voted for my use.
I didn't understand it. That's actually my issue that I don't understand.
I knew it.
But otherwise, please keep that.
We could have voted.
I didn't understand this.
Could have voted.
Yes.